Hi folks, so this is the Vanguard Endeavor ED4 binoculars 10x42. The box contains a warranty card, a user manual, a strap for the bag, a Vanguard padded neck strap for the binoculars, and a nice binocular bag. Front pouch has a Vanguard micro cleaning cloth, microfiber, a front pouch. Nicely padded with a belt loop in the back. Double zipper. And the binoculars. Well, here they are. They're surprisingly heavy at 780 grams. They have a nice substantial feel in the hand, and they have pebbled armory, rubber armory for protection. Nicely placed thumb indents, an attractive new design. I like the fact that you can fit your fingers through the open bridge. Allows you to really get a grip on them in the field. So the ergonomics are excellent. The field of view on these binoculars is 114 meters at 1,000 meters. They have premium Hoya ED glass, though they don't say the glass now is Japanese, like their previous models did, so I hope that's still the case. The lenses are fully multi-coated with SK15 roof prism. A terrific feature is the dioptic ring that's locking in the front here with plus or minus 4 dioptics. The binos are, of course, waterproof and fogproof, filled with nitrogen gas. The focus wheel is large and smooth. Feels nice. The body is aluminum, and both the optical and viewing lenses have branded protective rubber caps, though the rubber might not be of the highest quality. It says on the box and on a sticker on the bridge that the binoculars are made in Myanmar. But there's a somewhat hidden and small made in China mark embossed. There's also the tripod adapter, which is optional. That's also made in Myanmar. The part number on that is BA185. But anyway, Steiner make all their roof binoculars in China, and Leica and Zeiss have for some time been making their binoculars offshore in Asia and China. It's only the top of the line, most expensive binoculars that are now made in Germany. But for how long? Who's to say? On testing these binoculars in the field in various conditions, I found that to my eyes at least, they had very little chromatic aberration, which is amazing. And they're bright with good to edge edge-to-edge image clarity with little fall-off in color and focus. Of course, with many technical or optical products like binoculars, as the price steeply increases, there's a point of diminishing returns. These binoculars fit into an affordable mid-price tier, and at the time of recording, they cost, with tax, $651 Canadian. All in all, I'd say that these Endeavor 4s seem like a solid, well-made, well worth the price. In other words, I think you get a lot of bang for your buck with this set of binoculars. Bird and wildlife is what I'm going to be using these for, so I expect them to serve me for years to come. But time will tell, eh? I hope this information is helpful to others, and thank you for watching.